one is
these are some special integrals whose results should not only be derived but also be remembered, because they are going to form a part of a bigger problem for you later on. Okay. I'll start with the first one. If you recall, I've given you a list of standard trigonometric substitutions, right, when I was doing differentiation trigonometry. So in cases where you have x square plus a square arising, the best substitution is put x as a tan theta or a cot theta. Let's do it here. So it becomes integral of dx will become a secant square theta d theta. By this time you would have, you know, experienced that whenever tan x is or tan theta is substituted as t, or x is substituted as tan theta, dx will become a secant square theta d theta. In the denominator you'll have a square tan square theta plus a square. So, if I take a square common in the denominator, I will have a square 1 plus tan square theta. Correct? And sec square and 1 plus tan square will get cancelled off. So, we will be left with 1 by a integral d theta, which is 1 by a theta plus c, which you can write it as 1 by a. And theta from here will be tan inverse of x by a. Now I could have also solved this problem by doing one simple activity. Take 1 by a square, take 1 by a square common. So you will get dx by 1 plus x by a whole square, correct? Now do you remember while I was giving you integral as antiderivatives, I gave you 1 by 1. Yes. So can I say it is 1 by a square tan inverse of x by a
to 1 by a
divided by 1 by a. Divided by 1 by a means a will go out. So giving you 1 by a tan inverse x by a. This is an alternative way to get the same result. So going forward this result should be known to you. Integral 1 by x square plus a square is given as 1 by a tan inverse a square. Try B. In alternate method, I use this integral which I discussed in the beginning of the chapter. Refer to your beginning part of the chapter. First set of formulas. Do you see this integral there? If I make this as x by a, what will happen to the result? This will become 1 by a and 1 by a will divide will go up. Correct? So this is what happened over here. Generalization, reverse chain rule, remember? And 1 by a square is outside, so 1 by a square made this as 1 by a. That is what is the result. So, Shark, if you have x is replaced with ax plus b, remember we used to divide by the coefficient of x. So, instead of x, you have 1 by ax. So, I'll divide by 1 by a. Dividing by 1 by a is equivalent to say multiplying with a. So that's why this a came up, but because of 1 by a square outside, it became 1 by a.
So is the second one 1 by a ln x minus a by a?
If I have to use a trigonometric substitution, what is the ideal substitution for such cases?
A sec theta.
So we will again use x as a sec theta. Under the circumstances, dx becomes a sec theta tan theta d theta. Correct? Yeah. Yes or no?
Right.
Second is substituted as either sine theta.
If let's do this. You can substitute. Okay. Now, if I substitute it here, I get numerator as a sec theta tan theta d theta. Whereas, can I say denominator becomes a square tan square theta? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
D theta.
Oh, my sir.
And then what?
A square tan square theta. So it becomes 1 by a sec theta by tan theta.
This becomes 1 by a.
Which becomes 1 by a
cosec theta d theta.
What does it become? Cosec theta d theta. My cosec theta d theta integration is
ln
mod
cosec theta,
minus mod theta plus c. Now I cannot leave my answer in terms of theta because theta is something which I have introduced in the problem by substituting x as a sec theta. So if I ask you if sec theta is x by a, what is cosec theta then?
1 minus root x.
Cosec theta would be hypotenuse by, yeah, this will be what? Under root?
X square
minus
a square.
And what is cot theta?
A by
root over
x square
minus a square, correct? Yes or no? So when I substitute it here, I get ln mod. Since the denominators are same, can I write it as x minus a under root x square minus a square?
Yeah.
Now, if I write the x minus a term on top as root of x minus a into root of x minus a, and in the denominator I write it as root of x minus a into root of x plus a, will that be fine?
Yeah.
So these two terms will get cancelled. Half power can be taken outside. So you would realize that your expression would convert to 1 by 2a ln x minus a by x plus a. And this is how we know the formula for dx by x square minus a square, which is 1 by 2a ln x minus a by x plus a. Is that okay? There is another easier way to solve the same problem, which you can do without using trigonometric substitution. Now as we are deriving it, the result should be known to you because you will not get a time to derive this every time. This will be a part of a big problem and then you cannot deviate from the problem and sit and derive these results. So integration results can only be known through multiple practice. When the power is half, you can write this as x minus a by x plus a whole to the power of half, right? This half I can put it down, no? In front of the log. I'm telling you an alternative way to do the same thing. For the second one, b1 is an alternative. We all know from partial fractions that we can write this as x minus a into x plus a. Correct? Which can easily be written as 1 by 2a, 1 by x minus a minus 1 by x plus a. Correct me if I'm wrong. So, instead of integrating this with respect to x, we can choose to integrate this term with respect to x. Correct? Which clearly becomes ln mod x minus a minus ln mod x plus a, which becomes 1 by 2a ln mod x minus a by x plus a. Much easier way to solve it. But irrespective of whichever way you take, you should reach the same result. Now, C you don't have to bother much because in C, your answer is minus of the integral which you have already derived. So if I take a minus of this, I will actually get my result. But normally the way it is written in the school textbooks is they take the minus as a power of this, so it becomes ln x plus a by x minus a, and in sometimes they will write it as ln a plus x by a minus x as well. Now you say they're not the same thing, but it doesn't matter, because your x minus a and a minus x within the mod sign will not matter. So normally in school or in competitive exams, they would write the integral of 1 by a square minus x square with respect to x as 1 by 2a ln a plus x by a minus x. Which step? Okay, if you don't understand this conversion, you try writing this as a by x minus a plus b by x plus a. You have done partial fractions in 11th. Try to get a and b. Your a will come out to be 1 by 2a, b will come out to be minus 1 by 2a. So I directly use it over here. Instead of writing this, you can write it as 1 by 2a minus 1 by 2a. It's the same thing. Okay, for question number D, so D again I would substitute x as a tan theta. So I'll get a secant squared theta d theta. In the denominator will I get sec theta? Correct? A get cancelled. Sec theta integral is ln sec theta plus tan theta. Now please note, sec theta would be 1 plus x square by a square under root, and tan theta would be x by. So basically it becomes ln x plus under root x square plus a square by a, correct?
Yeah.
Now normally what do? We write this as minus ln a plus c, and we combine this under one constant of integration. So your result would be ln x plus under root x square plus a square mod plus c. So this will be your answer. Okay. Yes, try out the other one.
Oh yes. Fifth one, sir.
Yeah.
Ln x y plus
e.
So there?
But that is nothing but ln x.
What happened?
Yeah.
I got ln x by plus c. That is nothing but ln x.
Mod x
plus c. Ln mod x plus c.
Try out e number. Question number e. What is substitute? So what will happen to dx? What will become a sec theta? Tan theta? C theta? Can I resist? For E, your answer should be ln x plus same thing. Should I derive the E1? Nothing. E is ln mod x plus under root x square minus a square dx.
A square.
There's a lot of similarity between the two formulas. It's almost the same expression, it's just that there is a minus sign in the case of this. So as in the problem, the result also changes. So let me derive the E1. Even again the approach is same. So you substitute x as c theta, a c theta. So dx becomes a c theta tan theta d theta. So denominator will become, sorry, numerator will become this term. Denominator will become a tan theta. So again integration of this will become a c theta plus tan theta. But this time, since your substitution is in terms of a c theta, other time it was a tan theta. So things will change slightly. This c theta will become x by a, whereas this tan theta will become under root of x by a whole square minus 1. Isn't it? Which becomes ln of x plus under root x square minus a square by a mod plus c. Please note, by log properties we can write it like this. And this can be combined as another constant of integration. So this is the result. Try the F1.
Sin plus x squared.
Are you done with the fifth one?
Sixth one
answer will be sin inverse x squared plus c. So just a quick request. Write down all these formulas on your own once again on a separate sheet of paper without referring to the derivation. Just write it down because we are going to use it very frequently. So just write down these six and write down the formula next to it. Or if you have a formula list which you are maintaining, add this formula to that. Guys, I think you should save initial few pages for writing the formula of this chapter. And there are many more to come actually. So, this you can also do it by the method which I use for tan inverse. You can take a outside, a square outside. Okay, and this is x by a whole square.
That is sine inverse.
Which is 1 by a sine inverse x by a. Divide by 1 by a, so a will go off. A gets cancelled. Or you can go for substitution x as a sine theta, a cos theta.